Hey everybody, how you doing? This is episode 59 of Dan's Expert Tips for authors, publishers, and speakers who want to make some money. I'm Dan Blanchard, the best-selling and award-winning author, speaker, and educator, as well as the Connecticut president of the Association of Publishers for Special Sales and the co-host of Mindalia TV. Today I'm here to talk to you about the beginners navigating the minefield. Yep, it's tricky out there. There's a lot of bumps in the road, a lot of mines in the field out there for us beginners, okay? And one of those mines that us beginners tend to run into a lot is not treating what we do like a business. Too often we treat it as a hobby, you know, or a creative outlet. I know I've done that, and a whole bunch of my friends have done that too. But at some point, you gotta start treating it like a business, and the sooner you do that, the better off you're gonna be. All right, the bigger impact you'll have. And one of the things you gotta do is you gotta just deliver what people want, but do it in a way that you kind of stand out. However, creativity alone, remember, creativity alone is not enough. You need to do more than just be creative, okay? You gotta treat it like a business, okay? And here's the other thing. As much as we don't like this, people really do judge a book by its cover. So if you're an author and you got a book, you gotta have a good book cover. Okay, and not just a good book cover, but you gotta look good like a professional, like a business, and like a lot of places, because people judge books by their cover, right? So don't think your creativity is gonna freaking win out in this one. People judge you by the way you look and sound. They judge your book by its cover, okay? So here's the thing, we all have blind spots, all right? So we need outside help. We need to get editors to see where our writing's falling down, but we're not seeing it. We need book cover designers and et cetera. You know what I'm saying? Social media help, you know? We just need help, all right? And that's just how it goes. The doctor doesn't operate on himself, right? Even though he's talented, he doesn't operate on himself. We all got blind spots, all right? So listen, if you have a book, your book is your business, okay? It really is. So it would help if you positioned that book early as possible and try to know how you're going to make money. Is this book going to be a series? You know, are you going to do a consulting from your book, right? Are you just trying to build your email list from your book, right? Are you trying to get speaking from your book? Because you can plant these things in your book if you know how you're going to position your book so that your business can make some money. Right? So definitely try to. I mean, too many people don't position a book ever, and if they do, it's late in the game, right? So here's another one. Don't ignore other markets. Too many beginners do that. Right? If you got a book, think about Kindle. Think about audiobooks. Think about non-traditional sales and special sales with non-traditional markets. I mentioned that in a previous episode. I mean, can you sell your book at the airport bookstore? Can you sell your book, if it's a sports book, can you sell your book at, like, let's say Dick's Sports or any of those places? If you got a book on recipes, can you sell your book at a bakery? All right? Can you sell your books to associations, nonprofits, governmental agencies? Can you sell your books to Little League baseball teams, book clubs? All right? So don't forget about those, a lot of non-traditional markets and special sales. All right? I have an episode earlier that you can go back and listen to if you want some more information on that. Okay, here's another big mistake that beginners run into is quitting too early. You got to think about this as like your non-traditional college education. I mean, think about it. People spend 4, 5, 6 years in college, spend tens of thousands of dollars with no guarantee for a job, no guarantee for making money. All right? So, and when we spend like 1 year with writing a book and spend a little teeny bit of money and then quit, you know what I'm saying? We quit because it didn't work out so good. Think about if you did that with college, right? Or anything, right? So I want you to think this is long-term and think of like Thomas Edison. Thomas Edison found 10,000 things that didn't work. So before you found the one thing that did work and the light bulb at least worked the best, all right? So we need to be looking for like our Thomas Edison moments, all right? That didn't work out so good, but this one did a little bit, you know, but maybe there's something else could work better. So let's just do that. Don't quit too early, okay? Remember, this is our non-traditional college education, our real-world education, okay? And here's another pitfall, is that too many of us expect too much from our first book. We think we're going to publish that first book and be rich beyond belief and not have to work again. And when that doesn't happen, right, which for most of us doesn't, when that doesn't happen, we crash and burn. And for those that it does, you know, they run into complacency, so that's a problem too. All right, so again, think of it as your non-traditional college education. All right, don't expect too much from your first book. It's part of your education, all right? Here's another one. Writing too wide. All right, if you write too wide on too many topics, okay, you're gonna kill your momentum in your niche. All right, so you want to work on your niche first and then kind of work out from there slowly things that are related, okay? And finally, I would say build your audience as early as possible. Pound social media or whatever you have to build that audience as early as possible. Too many people just keep writing their books or doing their products or doing their services, waiting for the audience to come to them. No, you got to go out and you got to build that audience, and then you'll see them coming to you. Well, I hope this episode 59, Beginners Navigating the Minefields, was helpful. I'll be back pretty soon, very soon, with episode 60. But in the meantime, be sure to check me out at danblanchard.net and granddaddysecrets.com, and I'll catch up with you real soon. Take care now.